Hi, very good morning. I'm Dr. Janak Patel. I'm a general physician. Again, I'm not a radiologist. I'm not an expert in radiology, but still, I'll try to make subject as simple as possible so that you can understand very well. Today, we'll be now talking about how you start reading an X-ray chest. And in that X-ray chest, how will you read regarding a bony cage, soft tissue shadows, and breast shadows? These are the three headings which we'll be covering in today's topic. So while you look at the bony cage, you look at the rib, you look at the sternum, you look at the vertebra, you look for cervical ribs, and you look for clavicle. That is in a bony cage. You look at the position of the person, whether it is normal or rotated. You look at the soft tissue shadows and you look at the breast shadows. So these are the headings which we are going to cover up today. So in a bony cage, always you start looking at the bony surfaces. There are three main structures: sternum, vertebra, and ribs. As such, the clavicle comes in the part of a chest. You also look at the clavicle. So we can include clavicle in that. What you look for in those structures? Symmetry, deformities, fracture, any mass, any calcification, any lytic lesions, any abnormality. In a spine, we look for scoliosis, kyphosis, any erosion, etc. These are all the things. Because secondary to this bony cage, you can have change in the structure of a bony cage, which will result into lung function disorders and cardiac function disorder also. So bony cage is important from that point of view, and it can alter the X-ray interpretation. So first we look at the ribs. So we start with ribs, sternum, spine, shoulder girder, clavicles, etc. So we'll be taking one by one. You can see here, when you look at the X-ray chest in a PA view, you will see the spine here. Now you cannot identify which spine is where. So in a PA view, the spine, you may not be able to identify very clearly. But if a picture is good, you can make out only scoliosis. You cannot identify kyphosis is there, there is an erosion of the vertebra or not. Same way sternum also, you cannot identify sternal deformities. So in a PA view, you cannot identify vertebra and sternum properly. While you can see a ribs and clavicle, two structures you can see very clearly. Scapula we are as such not interested when we are talking about X-ray chest. So lateral view will give you an idea regarding the sternum and spine. So for those two structures, that is sternum and spine, you will have to have a lateral view. And for ribs and clavicle, you will require shoulder girder. We can say you will require a PA view. So these are the things what you will be looking for. So in a PA view, you look for the ribs, you look for the sternum, mainly ribs, shoulder girdle, and clavicles. While in a lateral view, you will look for the spine and you will look for the sternum, those two structures. So you can see clearly here, you can see the spine. There's a slight deformity which you can see, but you cannot identify which vertebras, where, etc. Sternum also you can't identify clearly, but you can see the ribs clearly. So you can look regarding the ribs, you can look for the clavicle, and you can see girdles, shoulder girdles, and you can look for even cervical spine, additional cervical spine. So these are the structure you will be looking for. So we start with ribs. So you will have to calculate the, this will be the posterior end and this will be the anterior end. These are anterior ends. So you can look at the anterior end, you can look at the posterior end. So look on both the sides. Counter check again. Look at the upper border, look at the inferior border. This is inferior border, this is upper border. Look on both the sides. And whenever you look at the clavicle, you can first see the medial end of the clavicle to find out the rotation of the patient. Because if there is a rotation, there will be misinterpretation of heart size. And even sometimes, it can produce a false images in X-ray chest. So rotation should be considered. And look at the fracture of clavicle, deformities of clavicle, etc. And in a case of what we call as apical view or lordotic view, clavicle will be seen here. Clavicle will be out of the way. And you will be able to see the apical lobe very clearly. So you look at the ribs, you look at the clavicle, and you look at the shoulder girdle. Now, whenever you look at this particular bony cage, you start calculating the ribs from posterior side. Say this is first, this is second, this is third, fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh, eighth, and ninth. So you start calculating that. This is scapula, this is clavicle. So start, and this is the vertebra which is seen in the center. Here you will be able to see much better. Say this is, we have labeled here. This is first, this is second, this is third, this is four, five, six, seven, eight, nine. So this is X-ray taken in a very nice deep inspiration. So you can see these are the posterior part and these are the anterior. These are the anterior. One, two, three, four, five, and six. So if you see the six anterior end, it is a good inspiration. Or look at the posterior ribs, posterior part of the ribs, it should be more than nine. We say almost 10. So if that is seen, it is based in deep inspiration. So that can be. And you look at the shape, you look at any deformities, upper border, inferior border, any swelling, any lytic lesion, any calcification, any fractures or abnormality in the shape. Now we'll be showing you some of those. And this will be lateral view. This will be the vertebra. You can see vertebra. This is an intervertebral space. You can see this intervertebral space. And these are the vertebra. This is scapula. And this is sternum. So you can see sternum and spine much better in a lateral view. So first look at the cervical spine. Look for cervical spine if you can identify. Then look at calcification. Look for subcutaneous emphysema, trachea position. If you can see cervical spine clearly, and if there is a cervical rib, then look for the disc space, any lytic lesions, erosions, etc., or any deformities. Now, in this particular picture, you will have to see soft tissue and the spine together. Now, if you look here in this particular, you can see the ribs clearly. You can see the ribs clearly. And look at the upper border. This is upper border. This is inferior border. Upper border, inferior border. Look at those particularly. Now, if you look in this particular X-ray, you can see there is an additional spine. Now, this is arising from cervical spine. This is an additional rib. As it is arising from a cervical rib, this is called cervical rib. So there is a bilateral cervical rib. Bilateral cervical rib. Clear cut. Now this can produce compression of the brachial plexus and it can produce tingling numbness. And it also can compress the vascular tree. Now if you look here at the inferior border, there is a slight notch. There's a slight notch. Now this will happen. Here it is better seen. You can see this notch. This will be typical in a case of, you can see a notch here. Normally you don't see. So if you see a notch, this will be happening only in one condition, coarctation of aorta. rib notching in coarctation of aorta. You can see much better here. See this rib notching. This is because of the artery which becomes dilated and tortuous, and it will be very common in case of a coarctation of aorta. So do remember that. While the notching, superior notching, the notching of the upper border will be very common in rheumatoid arthritis, SLE, hyperparathyroidism, Marfan syndrome, neurofibromatosis, etc. That is called superior notching. And inferior notching is only in case of what we call classical, what we call as coarctation of aorta. That is the main classical picture. Now, inferior rib notching, you can see sometime only on one side if a person has undergone blalactosic operation, which is a union between the two major arteries in subclavian artery occlusion. Blalactosic operation, what is being done in a coarctation. So, in an aortic coarctation, when you see, you can have a unilateral rib notching, particularly on the inferior surface. But bilateral rib notching you can come across in coarctation of aorta, Takayasu disease, in a Fallot stetrology sometime you can see, in pulmonary atresia, etc. These are all because of a artery which is running, intercostal arteries, they produce rib notching. Now, cervical ribs will usually produce what we call as a compression syndromes. So look for cervical rib, and if there is a good size of a cervical rib, it can cause thoracic outlet syndrome, or we call it a compression syndrome. Short form we call TOS, thoracic outlet syndrome. It can compress nerve bundles, it can compress vein, it can compress artery, depending upon what it compress accordingly. And look for what we call as a sclerotic metastasis, what can be seen. Now you can see here, there is a metastasis here. So this is a picture which is showing you a metastasis. If you look at this rib, look at this rib. There is a metastasis here. This is cervical rib. This is a small rib, not much bigger. Here, it is quite big enough. So this is cervical rib. SSRI cervical rib, you can call. This is bilateral, this is only one side. On this side we don't have. So this is only on the left side. Now you can see an additional soft tissue materials, and you can see an opaque material. The person, this is a pacemaker, these are the pacemaker wire. You can see two wires are going inside, so this is a dual pacing. There is a central line which is going on. This is a tracheal tube. If you see properly, there is one little darker ring like shadow which is seen here. Of arrow has been pointed out, and that is a heart valve. So person has undergone a valve replacement. So whenever you see any particular x-ray, please look for that. And you can see a suture valves, suturing, which is being done. Can see these sutures. Sutures, can you see? Yes. You can sometimes see multiple fractures. You can see a multiple fractures of fourth rib. Fourth rib. This is multiple fractures. Fourth rib has undergone a multiple fractures. And this will produce flail chest. Here also there are multiple fractures. One, two, three fractures are seen. But there is a callus formation. So this is an old fracture. This is an old fracture. So you can have sometime in an x-ray picture, you can have a fresh fractures which can produce a single fracture or multiple fracture. And if there are multiple fracture of multiple ribs, it can produce a dangerous condition we call a flail chest, which can be an emergency, and they require an emergency surgery fixation. Now you can see here, this rib is showing you a lytic lesion. This is a lytic lesion. So that lytic lesion is from CA thyroid. So try to identify such things which may not be related to lung or may not be related to what we call as a cardiac, but try to identify those things. Again, you can see here, this is a lytic lesion. And here, the three ribs, these are united together here. And this is a congenital fusion of a ribs. But such deformity should not be misdiagnosed as malignancy. You can see again a lytic lesion here. That is because of secondary metastasis. Again, you can see there is an erosion of a rib here because of a Penkos tumor. There is an opacity seen here. So this is a Penkos tumor which is eroding the second rib on the left side. So that can be easily identified. Now regarding a sternum, based seen in a lateral x-ray, you can see excavatum, carinatum, and sometimes we call it straight back syndrome. So these are the three common things you can identify as far as sternum is concerned. So we'll show you all those things. So all these conditions are assessed by PA and lateral view. So pectus excarinatum, you will be able to see that much better in a lateral view. And these are the conditions where you can have excarinatum. These are all the congenital conditions. Turner syndrome, Marfan syndrome, Ehlers-Danlos, Noonan's, trisomy 18, trisomy 21, homocystinuria, osteogenesis imperfecta, etc. So pectus excavatum is congenital, very rarely acquired. In acquired, rickets is one of the common conditions. And once in a while, because of excavatum, you can see pseudocardiomegaly. And there's a false prominence of pulmonary artery. So if you look in a normal person, you can see this sternum straight like this. This is middle mediastinum. In front of the heart, there is what is called as a retrosternal space. You will have a very nice retrosternal space. And behind the heart, this is a retrocardiac space. And this is a posterior mediastinum. So you can see clearly in a lateral view. So this is a retrosternal space. This is sternum. This is scapula. And this is the posterior portion behind the heart. And this is a spine which you can see clearly. So here sternum is absolutely normal. Now if you see here, can you see the sternal deformity? So that retrocardiac space will be obliterated because of that sternal deformity. And this will happen in an excarinatum. This is excarinatum and this is excavatum. This is inward. This is outward. So in an emphysema, the sternum will be bulged out. So this we call as a excavatum. Excarinatum. Or carinatum. And here, the sternum is inside deformity. So that is excavatum. It is inside. You can see the shape. This is inside. And because of this, you can have a false impression of cardiomegaly. Excavatum. And carinatum. You can see here, this is inside. This is curved out. You can see these are all steel wire sutures. So some surgery has been done. Some surgery. There is an endotracheal tube also here. Or this may be tracheostomy tube. This may be tracheostomy tube. And these are lot of suture wires. And you can see almost the full mediastinum is pushed here. Again, lot of suture wires. Is that clear? Okay. And you can see this is one valve which is being placed. You can see clearly this valve. So this is the valve which has been replaced. So this is a prosthetic valve which is being replaced. So this is a replacement of a prosthetic valve. And looking at the position, this is looking like an aortic valve. Now, when you look at the thoracic spine will look like this. And this will be in a lateral picture. This will be seen in a lateral picture. And you can see here, this is scoliosis. This is kyphosis. In an emphysema, you will be seeing kyphosis more common. And sometimes you can have a scoliosis because of the other pathophysiology which is present in a case of a spine. You can see very nice kyphosis. Very nice kyphosis. And because of this, there will be also rib deformity and sternal deformities. This is scoliosis, plain simple scoliosis. Sometimes you may be able to identify some of those deformity even in a PA view. As far as scoliosis is concerned, this you will be able to identify in a PA view or AP view. But if you want to identify kyphosis, you need a lateral picture. This can be identified only in lateral picture, not in a PA view or AP view. Now here if you see, you can see clavicle here. You can see a girdle here. Here, that is missing. So person has undergone a complete amputation, four quarter amputation. So entire that scapula, etc. are missing here. This is a condition where the person has been operated for some pathophysiology in the upper arm. Now there are some soft tissue shadows which you can see. And one of the soft tissue shadow which you can see is air in the subcutaneous tissue. These are the air in the subcutaneous tissue. So this is called surgical emphysema, or we call subcutaneous emphysema. So usually this is because of the air which leaks out from a pneumothorax into the subcutaneous tissue. So whenever you see such things, you try to identify that there is a pneumothorax here. You can see the border of the lung here. And from this, the air has leaked out into the subcutaneous tissue. So this is the left side pneumothorax with subcutaneous emphysema. Is it clear? So try to identify that. Here also you can see that this side, you can see the border of the lung. This is the pneumothorax. This is having no markings, no vascular markings. So this is the pneumothorax. You can see a deep sulcus sign also. This is a brace shadow. There is a fracture clavicle. So this has to be a traumatic etiology. This has to be a traumatic etiology. These are the electrodes. There is an endotracheal tube which is being put. So this side, there is a pneumothorax. And secondary to pneumothorax, you can have air which can leak out and can produce surgical emphysema. You can see there are multiple fractures of the ribs. And this all black lines are because of surgical emphysema, or we call subcutaneous emphysema. You can see an emphysema here, linear lines between the skin and muscles. We call as a subcutaneous emphysema, or we call surgical emphysema. And this has to be traumatic etiology. Again, you can see a fracture clavicle, fractures of ribs. These are fracture ribs, and that has produced surgical emphysema, right clavicle fractures. And you can see the fracture ribs here also. So this has to be traumatic etiology. You can see fractures. And there is a subcutaneous emphysema. Subcutaneous emphysema. So this is a fracture rib, and these are black lines you can see. This is in a subcutaneous tissue. So you call that as surgical emphysema. You can see this is in a pectoralis muscle. Air has moved, pushed into subcutaneous tissue, and even in along the muscle lines. You can see a lot of air in here, and this has to be because of a traumatic etiology. You can see a lot of airs, and even you can see a continuous line, diaphragm line, which separates out the heart border from diaphragm. So this is called continuous diaphragm sign. We'll be showing you further in other x-rays. So this is because of a pneumomediastinum, and you've got a surgical emphysema too. You can see air in the mediastinum. You can see here air between the aorta. So this is pneumomediastinum. And pneumomediastinum can produce a continuous line of diaphragm. Usually in a normal x-ray, you will not be able to see. If I show you here before, in some of the x-rays, here you cannot identify the diaphragm and heart separately. Here also you cannot identify. Now in this particular, you can see that diaphragm is continuous. You can see the continuity of the diaphragm. This is the air in the mediastinum. We call pneumomediastinum. Now you can see here again. These are multiple fractures, ribs, multiple fracture. This will produce flail chest. Flail chest. And this flail chest, meaning the chest will move in during inspiration. And during expiration, it will move out in opposite direction. Normally, when the person breathes, chest expands. Well, this portion, which is separated out, because there are multiple fractures of the ribs. This has got fracture, this is fracture, and there are multiple. So this portion is separated from the attachment. So this particular portion will move in during inspiration and will move out in opposite direction during expiration. So other portion during inspiration will move out while this portion will move in. So the lung expansion will be poor and it will produce severe respiratory distress. And this requires fixation, surgical intervention. So this is a multiple fracture ribs producing a flail chest. Now as far as the breast tissue is concerned, look at the breast tissue shadows. Sometimes if you don't look at that, you misinterpret as consolidation, collapse, or sometimes even as a metastasis. So always have a look at that particular structure. So you can see this here, both sides it is present clearly. And on one side, here the shadow is little more, soft tissue shadow is there, extra shadow is there. So this is because of the mass effect. Mass effect. Is it clear? And here you can see that gynecomastia, dense breast tissue. This will be in a male person. So that is gynecomastia, right? While if there is an increased density on one side, right side, this can be sometimes misinterpreted as a consolidation, etc. So do look at those particular conditions which may not be involving lung tissue. You can see clearly the borders, very clear. Now if you look here, you can see a border of the breast shadow. Well, here on this side, you can't see the breast shadow. So left side breast has been removed. So this is left mastectomy. Very commonly that is being done for a CA breast. Here you can see again, left mastectomy, beware of remaining nipple mimicking a nodule. So sometimes that may be mistaken as a nodule. This is roughly looks like that particular structure. Is it clear? So try to identify that. So these are all the things which we have talked today. So try to look at the bony cage, soft tissue shadows and breast shadows. And whatever I can show you. I may not have shown you all the other conditions which can be there. So I end my lecture here. We'll be seeing you